No matter what that chap in your local bar might tell you about Wallaroo copper mining shares or the horse running in the 330 that simply cannot lose, there's not too many surefire investment prospects around today. But here's one that you can drive the kids to school in. It's the Morris Minor, currently enjoying a tremendous renaissance in the motoring world. It's in the unique position of being an obsolete model that people are deliberately choosing in preference to a brand new car. Not something that's happened for the other small cars that came and went during the Morris Minor's long production run, from 1948, in fact, through to 1971. Now, all this demand for miners has had a marked effect on the prices of the cars. They've been going up and up, to the extent that a fully rebuilt, pristine Morris Traveller can now be worth up to £4,500. Like this beautiful Traveller that's been restored by Charles Ware's Morris Minor Centre in Bath. Charles, hello.
Hello, yeah.
What sort of people drive the Morris Minor nowadays?
Well, the people who've always driven them. The average ownership of people who come to us to get their cars restored is anything up to 15 years, in some cases 30 years with the same car.
And all sorts of people from all sorts of walks of life?
Indeed, every walk of life you can imagine. The one thing that bonds them in common is the fact that they're not really interested in motor cars, but interested in getting from A to B quickly, efficiently, without any problems. Reliably, above all, and that's the reason people love Morris Minors.
And can they still get spare parts easily? I understand that Leyland, in fact, still make a lot of parts.
Yes, Leylands make all the wings, they make a lot of other body panels still, and they've got huge stock reserves of a number of parts anyway.
So we can say fairly confidently that the current sort of price climb in the Traveller is going to keep going.
Yes, indeed. I don't think it'll go on as fast as it has been. It's about 350% over the last three years.
But it will continue in, what, to keep pace with new motor cars that people don't want to buy?
That's right. Yes, as an alternative to buying a Clubman or an Escort Estate or something, yeah.
Now, there's a lot of people around in the motor trade who think that you can pick up a scruffy Traveller for £250, you can spend £500 on it, and you can make a vast profit out of it. Now, you don't agree with that, do you?
No, I don't really, because I think it's a waste of time. You know, this is about basic transport, and people need that. And why be conned by motor traders?
You prefer to see them turn it into a proper new car?
Yes, tackle it gradually, year by year, as you can afford to do it. It's an ideal DIY car.
What sort of things does the DIY man have to look out for rust, for instance, in the body? What are the primary areas that are going to go?
Well, the primary areas that he must look out for are chassis problems, cross member, all the underfloor panels.
And rust in the wings? I noticed lots of them seem to go around the headlamps and on the front pillar there.
Yes, it was a weak design feature, and quite honestly, you can paint them and fill them if you like, but it'll always come back, so the only answer is new wings.
Now, on the Traveller in particular, wood rot is a special problem, isn't it?
Yes, it is, yeah. You see, the whole back end of the car is, in fact, aluminium and wood. Most people think it's sort of applied like a mini Countryman or something like that. In fact, it's a basic structural matter. And unless the wood, this is the corner post, one of the back ends. Now, unless the whole structure is in first-class order, in an accident situation, the whole back end can collapse. So it's vitally important that one uses timber that's properly made, properly jointed and properly put together.
And in fact, apart from the timber, the interior of the car must be a very expensive item as well.
Well, yes, indeed. I mean, some people, if you're having, say, a Connolly Hyde interior like a Rolls-Royce, and we do have occasional customers for that, it's £1,500.
Charles, thanks very much indeed. That sounds petrifying.